In this video, we'll walk through how to clean up the floor plan of Manos Hatzidakis' house, which we scanned in the previous video. We'll be using the Windows software that comes with the 2Dscanner, the editor. First, I'll use the crop command to remove all the distant points. The application suggests a crop rectangle containing all the good lines. In this case, I'll enlarge it a little by clicking and dragging. Then, by pressing space, all the points outside this rectangle are selected. Using the delete key and confirming, we can remove them. Now, let's take a general look at how we move around an editor. By holding down the middle mouse button, we can navigate the drawing, while with single middle click opens a pop-up menu with many commands. Use left click and draw a rectangle to zoom in this area. Double middle click equals to zoom all. Draw a rectangle using right click, and all the points in it will be selected. With delete key, all the selected points are deleted. Let's clean some more points now for a better drawing. The big advantage of the editor is that the red lines are automatically generated after the deletion of points. These lines are the statistical lines generated with the least square method. Now let's explore the other features of the editor. Here we see the visibility section. We can select which elements we want to see in our drawing. Raw values are the measurements without the inclination correction. If you level 2Dscanner, then the difference is practically zero. Usually we work with the corrected ones. With points, we can see the circles around all scan points. If you have a large drawing, turning points off helps for better performance. The signal shows the signal quality of the measurements. Large circles represent bad conditions. We can use the low signal filter to hide these measurements. As you can see here, the bad signal points are missing. Here is a better demonstration in the full drawing. From here, you can see the position of 2Dscanner for each scan. And with this one, notes or stickers. The traced lines are the red lines automatically generated by the software. And the max deviation is the distance between the red line and the most far away point. For these two lines, for example, the most distant points are 11.7 and 10.5 millimeters from the lines. And in this field, we set the maximum allowed distance of a point from the line. So if we set this to 50 millimeters, more points will be considered in line. As you can see, we have double scanned this area. We can see the difference between the lines with the measure tool. So the difference is actually around 5 millimeters. Let's set this back to 15. And we move on. From here, we can show the automatic dimensions. And from here, we can increase the size. In a place like this, there is no point at all. The automatic dimensions are for cleaner drawings like ceiling scans. So I turn it off. These controls here helps to rotate the drawing or the selected scans. If nothing selected, the command applies to all scans. But if you select a scan, then only this will be rotated. Now let's undo these actions. With Control Z, like the low signal filter, we can use the long shot filter that will cut off all measurements with value higher than this. And here we see the Show Hide List box. We can select individual scans or multiple using the Shift key, and do several actions like delete, or hide and show specific scans. You can also use these checkboxes to define the visible scans. And you can define the selected scans also. Be aware that visibility and selection are independent. Commands are executed for selected scans, even if they are hidden. This is done on purpose, so that you can work with the data you prefer without breaking the continuity of the drawing. Now let's undo this action and remove the long shot filter. Now we're ready to finalize the drawing. I'll just remove one more point. Let's now check the areas that were scanned twice. Here's the first overlap, using two corners. As you can see, there's a slight deviation, but it's not as large as it looks. If I delete this point, the line aligns more closely with the actual data. As you can see, the deviation is around 6 millimeters. These deviations are unavoidable. The most common cause is a low aiming angle, but several other factors may also contribute. We don't need this data, so I'll just delete it. I'll keep the more reliable data from the second scan. Let's check this corner. It was scanned 3 times. Scan 3 was created using 2 stickers. Its only purpose was to assist in joining scan 4 with scan 1. That wasn't necessary, because this corner was already available from scan 1, but we missed it. The application used the corner from scan 3 because it defaults to the latest data. Let's fix this. We'll hide scan 3 and move scan 4 to align with scan 1 at the corner point. Now we see that on the other side, there's some deviation. We'll fix it with a rotation. And now we can just delete the double scanned areas. Like before, we can clean these points from scan 2. And now we can remove scan 3. And scan 5 was created just for demonstration purposes. You can download these files from the video's comments section. This was a brief tutorial showcasing the capabilities of the editor. Thanks for watching. Happy scanning.